Let us look at surface tension of solutions. Here we have got three groups of solutions. We have the inorganic salts such as potassium chloride. We have alcohols such as ethanol. And we have the surface active agents such as CTAB. As the concentration of an inorganic salt such as potassium chloride increases, the surface tension of the solution increases. Consequently, potassium chloride will be less at the interface. This is because increased surface tension implies increased surface free energy, which is clearly unacceptable in thermodynamics. When we come to ethanol, here, the increase in concentration lowers surface tension. Consequently, there will be more ethanol molecules at the interface or at the surface compared to the bulk. And again, this is because this is thermodynamically acceptable. Now, when we come for the surface active agents, as the concentration of the surface active agent increases, the surface tension dramatically decreases and reaches a point and then stops. This point is called the CMC, the critical micelle concentration. Once again, there is increased concentration at the interface because of the reduction of the surface free energy due to the decreasing surface tension. So group one, as mentioned, increases surface tension as concentration increases, hence increasing surface free energy, which as we said is thermodynamically unfavorable. Now to minimize this thermodynamic increase in surface free energy, the species are excluded from the surface. We can't term this negative adsorption because there is less of the solute at the interface compared to the bulk. Examples of this, as mentioned, includes inorganic salts such as potassium chloride and sodium chloride, which we are always eating. Group two. Here, there is a reduction in surface tension as the concentration increases. And because there is a reduction in surface tension, there is a reduction in surface free energy, gamma A. Consequently, this is thermodynamically favorable. Hence, the concentration increases at the interface. Hence, considered as positive adsorption compared to that of the inorganic salts. In this group, we have the alcohols, the alkanoic acids, and the amines. Group three, which is actually a subgroup of group two. These two reduce surface tension drastically as their concentration increases up to a point, as mentioned earlier. Thereafter, concentration hardly increases the surface tension. These are called surface active agents. They have hydrophilic head groups, such as alkanoic acids, amines, and N plus R4. And a hydrophobic tail, usually a hydrocarbon chain. As shown in the diagram, the circle is the hydrophobic group, hydrophilic group, and the tail, which is usually hydrocarbon, is the hydrophobic tail. experimental proof. McBain experimentally proved the increased surface concentration at the interface for group 2 and group 3. What he did was to dissolve these in solution and use a trough initially made by Miss Pockel. He then used a microton blade to skim off the top layer for analysis. Let us look at measurements of surface tension. The most common one, which we have already covered before in lecture 2, is that of the capillary rise method. We can also measure surface tension using the Dunoy tensiometer. We can use the Wilhelm plate. We can also measure surface tension using the drop weight or the drop volume, but this is a dodgy method because the accuracy is very difficult to improve. We can use the spinning drop tensiometer now. This is for very low surface tensions. As mentioned earlier, method one was given behind. Method two was used in third year experiments 11 and 3. And method 4, I'll give it to you as homework. As for method 5, later in the course, I'll give an outline. Let us look at adsorption and orientation at interfaces. It's found that some compounds are soluble in both water and organic solvents. Examples include fatty acids with short hydrocarbon chains, such as methanoic acid, RCOOH, alcohols with OH, such as methanol, ethanol. In these, the hydrocarbon chain tends to drag them into the organic solvent, e.g. alkanes such as dodecane. The polar head group tends to drag them in the aqueous phase if they have a short chain. As the chain lengthens, they get adsorbed at the interface with the polar head groups in water and the hydrocarbon chain in the air or in oil. At this stage, adsorption is more favored to dissolution into a phase, as shown here. The first diagram on the left, we have the aqueous phase and the vapor phase. And the one on the right, we have the aqueous phase and the organic phase on top. At the interface at low coverage, hydrocarbon chains tend to lie flat on the water surface. At higher coverages, they take up a more upright configuration. This strong adsorption at the interface is called surface activity. Surface active materials are amphiphilic molecules, i.e., they have a polar group and a non-polar chain and a non-polar chain. We should also realize that surface activity is a dynamic phenomenon. It's not static. In other words, molecules are constantly getting into the interface and out of the interface. Packing at the interface expands the interface. But we should remember that surface tension contracts the surface. So these two phenomena are contradictory. Therefore, packing of the surface active molecules lowers surface tension. Thus, pi is equal to pi naught, no, gamma is equal to gamma naught minus pi, where gamma is the surface tension of the solution, gamma naught is the surface tension of the solvent or the host, and pi is the expanding pressure. Now the figure after this shows the lowering of surface tension by homologous series. Apparently, as the chain lengthens, the ability to lower surface tension increases. So longer hydrocarbon chains have great tendency to adsorb at the interface and has greater in surface tension lowering. Let us look at the diagram. Now, in this diagram, on the x-axis, we have the concentration in moles per decimeter cubed. And on the y-axis, we have got the surface tension in millinewtons per meter. As we can see, ethanol has a bit of surface activity, but it's not that great. And probably it never reaches CMC. But when we add 1CH2 to make it propanol, then the surface activity begins getting a little bit more serious. This is followed by butanol, as can be seen, and then N-pentanol, and by the time we're at N-hexanol, the surface activity is really great. A gentleman by the name Trobe observed that there was a relationship between the surface activity reduction and the change in number of CH2s. He found that each added CH2 in a homologous series reduces the required concentration by 3 for a given surface tension gamma. It should be noted that large reduction in interfacial tension between two liquids by addition of surface active agents leads to emulsification. In this case, gamma A is very, very small. If pi is greater than or equal to gamma naught, formation of microemulsion occurs.